morning to all of you. I'm Alpna, dear children. Today I would like to welcome you to my next chapter, that is types of sentences of class 5 from your grammar book. Okay, children, I have already explained you about the sentence. Anna? So today I would like to go in a brief manner for the types of the sentences. I have already explained you about the sentence, about the phrase. Now we will be going to discuss the types. Okay, how many types of sentences are there and where to use them, how to use in whatever situation. Okay, so let's begin with the definition. Sentence, as you already know, a group of words that makes complete sense is called a sentence. Now, to explain the assertive sentence, I would like to give some examples. Then later on, I will explain you the definition. Let's begin with the examples. Here, the sun shines brightly. That means this sentence is written with the capital letter and it ends with the full stop here. Now, it is having a positive effect. That is, the sun shines brightly. As we already know, the sun is very much bright. It is having a positive attitude. This also, the sentence explains us in a very good manner that it is a positive sentence starting with a capital letter and ending with a full stop. And in the second sentence, we went to Shimla by car. The meaning is very much clear that we have been to Shimla and by car. There were no students in the class. It is also very much clear that no students were there in the class. These sentences simply say or state something and they begin with a capital letter and end with a full stop. They state something. That means the first one states that sun shines brightly. Second one states that we have been to Shimla by car on a long years ago and there were no students in the class. It is very much clear here that these sentences state something. Okay? They are assertive or declarative sentences. Such sentences are known as declarative sentences or assertive sentences. An assertive sentence can either make a positive statement or a negative statement. That means what? Assertive statement can give you an effect of both a negative and a positive. That means it can give you a negative sense of sentence also and it can give you a positive sense of sentences also. Now we will begin with the affirmative sentence, which is a type of sentence. An assertive sentence that conveys a positive meaning is called an affirmative sentence. That means this assertive sentence, if convey a positive meaning, that is called as an affirmative sentence. For example, wait there. That means it is an order which is in a positive sense that please wait there. Mayank has finished his homework. That means it is very much clear that Mayank had already finished his homework. Richa has a task for you. That means Richa had given you some task and you have to do it. The meaning is very much clear. So it is having a positive meaning here. Those assertive sentences having a positive meaning is called as affirmative sentence. Second one, negative sentence. What is negative sentence? An assertive sentence that conveys a negative meaning is called as a negative sentence. That means it is not positive in nature. It is negative in sense. For example, do not wait here. Please don't wait. It is a negative attitude. Okay? So this sentence shows a negative sense. Richa has no task for you. That means Richa had not given you any task. It is a negative sentence. Third one, Mayank has finished his homework. Here, Mayank has not finished his homework. That means Mayank has not completed the homework. Here we have a huge discussion about the negative sense of sentence. Now, after this, I would like to explain some more sentences which are given in the book later. So, in the later half, we will see.